So, how do you find a dinosaur? And where do you know to look for one in the first place? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist teaching at Utah State University in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. In this video, you'll learn how to predict what types of rocks and locations are best for the discovery of dinosaurs. So here are the basics you need to find a dinosaur fossil. First, you need the right rocks. Rocks must be sedimentary, not igneous. Those are rocks formed from the cooling of magma or lava, and not metamorphic. Those are rocks that have changed due to pressure and temperature. In both igneous and metamorphic rocks, any dinosaur remains would be destroyed by the intense heat and pressure deep in the earth. Sedimentary rocks are the only type of rocks which preserve fossils. Second, the right time. The rocks must be of the right age. From the Mesozoic era, the age of dinosaurs. Locally, you might have rocks that formed before the age of dinosaurs or after the age of dinosaurs. So you need to look for the right layer of rock, which is within the Mesozoic era. This is a geological map of North America produced by the United States Geological Survey. The ages and types of rocks are color-coded, and the Mesozoic rocks are depicted in light green colors. The yellow and tan colors of rocks are much younger than the Mesozoic age, and those rocks are too young for dinosaurs, while the blue and purple rocks are too old for the dinosaurs. The red and orange rocks are igneous and metamorphic type rocks, and will also lack dinosaurs. We can see that Central Canada has the most green rocks in North America. This is centered around Dinosaur Provincial Park, located east of Calgary. As we head south, we see that green extends into Montana near this large reservoir called Fort Beck, which is where Tyrannosaurus Rex is found. The rugged Rocky Mountains have lots of pockets of green, especially in Wyoming, Colorado, and eastern Utah. There's even Mesozoic rocks out on the Great Plains. Out in California, we see Mesozoic rocks east of the Central Valley. And as we head into Mexico, we see green rocks, especially in Baja, Mexico. Out in Texas, we see many green rocks. And as long as we head out into the eastern states of the United States, we see a strip of green rocks that starts in Mississippi and Georgia and heads up all the way up the eastern seaboard along the Atlantic side, all the way up to New York City. In fact, the first dinosaur ever discovered in the United States was found right across from New York City in the state of New Jersey. And third, living on land. The rocks must be deposited in a terrestrial setting because all dinosaurs are terrestrial. Many of those Mesozoic rocks I showed you are marine rocks, deposited in a giant seaway that split the North American continent in two during the last part of the Mesozoic. It's really rare that you find a dinosaur in marine units, although some have been found in the past. Ancient aquatic reptiles like mosasaurs, plesiosaurs, and ichthyosaurs can be found in those rocks, but we'll see and learn that these creatures are related to a different group of reptiles. Dinosaurs can be found in urban settings, in forested land, and in the desert. Now, the desert is a good place to look because there is less things covering the rocks. But amazing dinosaurs have been found all over the world, and there's likely a good place to look for dinosaurs near you. Now you should know how to predict what types of rocks and locations are best for the discovery of dinosaurs.